Hello, this is Jack Jackson. In this video, we're going to be talking about measures of size. So this is one of the things that we'll be looking at in descriptive statistics, are several measures of size. In particular, in this video, we're going to be looking at frequency, relative frequency, and a few related concepts. So measures of size are the most basic measure of a data set. We can measure the size of a population, the size of a sample, of the entire thing, or parts of that with various characteristics. So we might divide a population into subparts and measure each of the subparts. And we have numerous graphical and numerical methods of measuring size. Of course, the most basic one is just to count things like population size and sample size. But we could also organize this into tables when we have more than just one or two numbers. So we might have a table of all the values, or a table of frequencies, relative frequencies, or cumulative relative frequencies. And we'll talk a little bit about what those last four things are here in just a minute. Now, there are also several graphical measures of size and way of representing the sizes of different parts of a data set. We have a stem and leaf plot, a dot plot, sometimes called a line plot, a circle graph, or sometimes called the pie chart, bar graph, histogram, pictograph, ogive, and Pareto diagrams. So these are just some of the ones that may exist, and there are many other types of graphs as well, but these are some of the most basic ones that we'll be talking about. So first of all, the most basic measures of size would just be the size of the whole thing. So remember, we use capital N for the population size and lowercase n for the sample size. So that's just the number of items in the entire either population or sample. Now, one of the simplest ways to represent data in some organized way is to organize it into a table. If the table has many variables of interest, then the table may be organized or sorted according to any one of the variables of interest. So, for example, I'm getting ready to show you a piece of a table that gives several pieces of information about the current and past presidents of the United States of America through President Obama. It is currently sorted by the order that the individual held the office, but it could also be sorted by any of the other variables that are there if we desired, if alphabetical order, if there's no inherent order in the thing. So we will be using this complete data set, not just the first part of the table that I'm going to show you, again, complete through President Obama, as one of at least a couple of data sets that we'll be returning throughout the notes and throughout this playlist. So multiple videos will be coming back to these same data sets. So here it is. You can see it's organized in a table. We have a title up the top, U.S. Presidential Information. We have the order that they were elected, and of course this is only the first part of the table for the first five entries. So first, second, third, fourth, and fifth presidents. This is their name, first, last name, comma, first name. George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe. For the first five, it has their party. So Washington and Adams were the Federalist Party, and the other three were the Democratic Republican Party, which is kind of the precursor to the Democratic Party. We have the term of office here. For example, George Washington, 1789 to 1797. And then John Adams took over in 1797, went to 1801, and so forth. We have the state that they're from here. We have the date of their birth in this column here, and the date of their death. One thing that's really interesting to me is always that John Adams and Thomas Jefferson were both died on the exact same day, which also happened to be the 4th of July. And since they were two of the authors, of course Thomas Jefferson being the primary author of the Declaration of Independence, and they had an interesting relationship there. Their religion here, their date, their age, they were when they were first inaugurated. In some cases, they held two terms, so they might be inaugurated more than once, but this is the first time. and how they were when they died. So, of course, there are many other pieces of information we could ask and want to know about the presidents, but this is just some information that's collected in this particular table. Now, notice it's organized. It's sorted in order here. We could sort it in alphabetical order by last name. We could sort it by party. It's kind of already, the order is already by term of office, but we could sort them in alphabetical order by state or whatever. So we have several different ways we could put them in order. One of the things that we're going to be interested in, and just so that we have some numerical data, I'll be looking at this age at inauguration here, 57, 61, 57, 57, 58. We can see how old they were when they were inaugurated, and we can look at that data. So I mentioned before that there are four things here that we might be interested in: frequency, relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and cumulative relative frequency. The frequency is just the count of how often something occurs. So we might say, well, let's just do count how many of these were Federalist, for example. Count how many for each party, for example. We could do relative frequency. So if we take the frequency of a category from a sample and then divide it by the size of the entire sample, then we obtain a relative frequency. So it's relative to that total amount. We could think of that as a percentage of the total amount. So they're often given in the form of percentage, but maybe given a decimal or fractional form. Usually, fraction form is going to be the exact way, and usually with percentages and often with decimals, then we'll round those off at some point. Now, cumulative frequency, if your data is ordinal or higher level data, then there's an inherent order to it. And then the cumulative frequency is the frequency, it's the sum of all the frequencies up to that point and including it. In other words, it's the number of data values which are equal or less than the given data value. And then cumulative relative frequency, you can think of accumulating the relative frequencies or doing the relative amount of the cumulative frequency, either way, and that is divide the cumulative frequency by the size of the entire sample. So let's see if we can put this into play here. So here is a table. This is just some made-up data. And suppose this is grade distributions on a particular test. Okay, this is completely made up. But let's say on this test, there were two Fs, one D, eight Cs, four Bs, and three As. Notice that the data is ordinal because there is an order to it, right? F is lowest, then D is next, C is higher, B is higher than that, and A is the highest. So here we have the frequencies. Let's see if we can fill out some of this chart. So see if you understood what I did, and see if you can compute the total for this line, and then use the total and these numbers to compute the relative frequency. Let's do it both as an exact fraction, let's say reduced fraction, and then also as a percentage, let's say rounded to a whole number. Percent, and then do the total down here. See if you can do it. I bet you can do that on your own. So if you would, go ahead and press pause, work through this column, and then come back and check your answer. Press pause now. Well, if you're back, you realize that all we have to do is add these up to get 18, and then we're just dividing each of these by 18. So 2 18ths, 1 18th, 8 18ths, 4 18ths, and 3 18ths. Now some of these reduce. Let's see, 2 over 18 reduces to 1 ninth. 8 18ths, we can cancel a 2 out, reduces to 4 ninths. 4 18ths similarly is 2 ninths. And 3 18ths, we can factor a 3 out and cancel, and that's 1 sixth. If we divide these out and long division, and we get a decimal, which we can round off. So this is 0.1 repeating, which is 11% approximately. This is 6%. Again, these are rounded off to the nearest whole number percent, 44%, 22%, and 17%. And of course, any time you add up the relative frequencies, you always get 1 or 100%. Okay, so relative frequency is just the percentage of, or fraction of the total. Cumulative frequency, then, is accumulating this. So this will be 2 here, and then this one will be what? 3, because it's that 2 plus that 1, and so forth. See if you can fill out the cumulative frequency column now. Press pause. Well, it's not too hard. The first one is just going to be the same here. And the next one, there's a couple ways you can get it. We can get the 3 by adding the 2 and the 1 to get 3. And similarly, we can get 11 by adding 2, 1, and 8 to get 11. We can also do it by just adding the 3, which is the 2 and the 1 together, plus the 8 here. So you can add the 1 above and the 1 over here, and that will do it. So to get 15, we could add the 11 to the 4, and then take that 15 and add 3 more to get 18. We could also get 18 by just adding them all up. All right, now go ahead and give cumulative relative frequencies too. Press pause now. Okay, well, you're back. All you have to do now, of course, is just take those and divide all of those numbers by 18. So 2 18ths, 3 18ths, 11 18ths, 15 18ths. Some of these reduce. I don't have the reduced versions written here. Let me go ahead and get those in there for you as well. Okay, so here they are with the fractions non-reduced, just dividing by 18, then reduce them. Let's see if I did that right here. This should just be the 2 over the 18, and that reduces to 1 ninth, which is 11%. 3 over 18, which reduces to 1 sixth. That's really 16.6 repeated percent, but it rounds off to 17%. 11 18ths doesn't reduce, that's 61%. 15 18ths, which is, let's see, cancel 3 out, so that's 5 sixths, 83%. And of course, 18 18ths is just 1, which is 100%. And of course, this last one is always going to be 100%. The first one's always going to be just whatever the relative frequency was for the first one. But the rest of them are going to increase between that lowest one and then 100%. Okay, again, the fractional values, whether reduced or not, are exact. The decimal, the percentage forms, are approximations. Okay, so that gives you a basic idea of what's meant by frequency, relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and cumulative relative frequency.